Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the second online class of computer science. This is me, your subject teacher, Ms. Farwa. Dear students, today we will talk about different devices that are used with computer systems in order to increase their capability of doing work and their efficiency too. But before that, let's have a recap of the devices that we have already talked and discussed about. The first most commonly used devices are the input devices that are used to send data to the computer if you want them to perform a specific task. For example, keyboard, mouse, scanner, joystick. On the other hand, if you want to display the result of the data that has been processed using different input devices, you need to have an output device. Commonly used examples of output devices are monitor, speakers, and printers. In front of you are few of the pictures and examples of input and output devices. Dear students, let's begin with chapter number 2. Peripheral devices. By the end of this chapter, you will be able to explain the functions of different input and output devices. You will be able to identify different input and output devices and explain what they are used for. Let's have a look at the introduction to peripheral devices. Peripheral devices are optional devices which are connected to the computer externally, means from the outside, not from the inner side, such as printer, scanner, tape device, microphone, and external modem. There are three types of peripheral devices: input, output, and storage, as these three are the most common operations that need to be performed whenever we talk about different devices of the computer. The input devices help us interact with the computer or send data to the computer. Output devices helps us to produce the results on the computer, whereas storage devices are used to store the processed data. But there are some devices that fall into more than one category. Consider a CD-ROM drive. You can use it to read data or music, and you can use it to write data to a CD. Then comes external peripheral devices. So any peripheral device that is not housed in the computer cabinet, for example, monitors, keyboards, mic, and printer are inherently external devices. However, drives, network adapters, and modems may also be external devices. Let's have a look at the internal peripheral devices. Any device that is built in or is housed inside the computer cabinet, like motherboard, processor, CD-ROM, hard drives, etc. In front of you is the back panel of the case, means this is the back side of the CPU that you normally have at your home or at your workplace. There are few of the ports with which you can connect the external or internal peripheral devices. Now we will talk about few external peripheral devices and few external peripheral devices in detail. The first one is the keyboard, which belongs to the category of input peripheral devices. The keyboard in front of you has been labeled in detail, and today we will talk about all the functioning of these labeled keys in detail. Alt key, also known as alternate key. A computer key that you press together with another key so that the other key does something different from what it usually does. You can also refer to this key simple as Alt. Arrow key. One of four computer keys marked with an up, down, left or right arrow, used for moving the cursor. Backspace. The key that you press on a keyboard to move one space backwards in a document. Caps lock. A key on a computer keyboard that makes all the keys produce capital letters. Character set. A complete set of letters, numbers, or symbols that can be used by a computer. Command key. On some computers, a key that you press together with another key to make the computer do a particular thing. Control. The control key on a computer keyboard helps you to control different functioning of the computer operations. A key on a computer keyboard that is used in combination with other keys for doing particular operations. This key usually marked CTRL, abbreviation control. The control key on a computer keyboard. Delete key. A computer key that removes characters. This key is sometimes simply referred to as DEL. Enter key. A key on a computer keyboard that makes computer perform an action or start a new line of writing. Escape. A key on a computer keyboard that allows someone to stop an action, leave a program, or return to a previous menu. This key is usually marked ESC. Function key. A special button on a computer keyboard that is used for a particular operation in a program. The keys near the top of the keyboard marked F1 to F12 are function keys. Hotkey. A key on a computer keyboard that provides a short way of performing a set of actions. Key. One of the parts that you press on a keyboard to make it produce letters, numbers, etc. Keypad. The part at the side of a computer keyboard that has number keys and arrow keys on it. Numeric keypad. The part of a computer keyboard to the right of the main keys that has keys with numbers on them. Numlock. A computer key that you press to make the number keys below it enters numbers and not to be used for moving up and down a document. Pound key. American, the hash key on a telephone keypad or a computer keyboard. Return key. A key on a computer keyboard that makes the computer perform an action or start a new line of writing. Shift key. The key that you press on a computer keyboard when you want to write a capital letter. Shortcut. Computing a computer icon or a combination of keys on the keyboard such as Alt plus C that helps you to do something on the computer more quickly. For example, go to a particular program or copy information. Spacebar. The long narrow bar at the front of a computer keyboard that you press to make a space between words when you are typing. The key with the asterisk symbol on a telephone keypad or computer keyboard is known as a star key. Tab. Computing a button on a computer keyboard or typewriter that you press to move several spaces along the same line. Tab key. A tab on a computer keyboard. Toggle. Computing a key or command equals to instruction on a computer that you use to move from one operation or program to another and then come back again. Now let's talk about the second category of input peripheral device, which is known as a mouse. The mouse in front of you has been labeled in detail. There are 5 basic operations that can be performed using a mouse. Number 1, you can click. Number 2, you can double click. Number 3, right click. Number 4, to point. Mouse is also known as a pointing device. And number 5, to drag. You will find a button on the right side of the mouse, then on the left side of the mouse. In the middle of these 2 buttons, you might see a wheel. Sometimes in few of the mouse, there is a wheel button, and most of the times it is not there. Then comes the palm rest, from where you can hold the mouse and perform the rest of the operations that can be done using a mouse. the third category of input peripheral devices. This device is known as a joystick. Joystick is an input device consisting of a long stick that pivots on a base and reports its angle or direction to the device it is controlling. Joysticks are often used to control video games and usually have one or more push buttons whose state can also be read by the computer. How a joystick works. Basically, joystick detects the direction you are holding the stick in by use of an electronic switch. There is a printed circuit board inside the joystick base. The terminals can't complete the electric circuit when the joystick is in a neutral state. By this, it means the stick is not pressing the contacts into the on position. Next category is the touch screen. A touch screen is an input device that allows users to operate a PC by simply touching the screen, like you use your cell phones. You just tap your screens and you just open whatever you want to. So this is how all the touch screens work. The display screen has a sensitive glass placed on it and we code the desired input by touching it. A touch screen is based on CRT, means cathode ray tube technology, that accepts direct on-screen input. Let's have a look at the advantages of a touch screen. Touch screens provide end users an opportunity to interact with the computer, improving the human-computer interface and improving the user's experience. Touchscreens provide an easy-to-understand initiative interface for the human brain. Fumbling with a mouse and keyboard isn't always the easiest thing to do, and touchscreens technology can help. It saves time. The next category is of a scanner. Scanner is an input device. It reads the graphical images or line art or text from the source and converts it into digital information and sends it to the computer. Scanner is an electronic device that scans data. Scanners are used to give large volume of data as input to the computer. Let's have a look at different types of scanner. Number 1. Flatbed scanner. It is the most versatile and commonly used scanner. Number 2. Sheet fed scanners. Similar to flatbed scanners, except the document is moved and the scan head is immovable. Number 3. Handheld scanners. Similar to flatbed scanner, but rely on the user to move them instead of a motorized belt, less quality. Fourth category is of the drum scanners. These are used by the publishing industry to capture incredibly detailed images. They use a technology called photo multiply tube, PMT. In PMT, the document to be scanned is mounted on a glass cylinder. At the center of the cylinder is a sensor that splits light bounced from the document into 3 beams. Each beam is sent through a color filter into a photo multiplier tube where the light is changed into an electronic signal. The next category is of barcode reader. What is a barcode and what is it used for? Barcodes are applied to products as a means of quick identification. They are used in retail stores as part of the purchase process, in warehouses to track inventory, and on invoices to assist in accounting, among many other uses. What is a barcode and why is a barcode reader used? A barcode reader, also called a price scanner or point of sale POS scanner, is a handheld or stationary input device which is used to capture and read information contained in a barcode. I hope you enjoyed the lecture. Thank you very much.